The 1420 Sports Bar Podcast, show number 276, part of the Belly Up Network of shows. The Super Bowl preview show tonight brought to you by Manscaped and Manscaped.com. Go to Manscaped.com, use promo code 1420SCAPED at Manscaped.com and save yourself 20% and get yourself free shipping on all of their men's personal grooming needs. Got a lot of stuff, more than razors, on there on manscaped.com. So make sure you guys go there tonight. Dave, before we get going on the Super Bowl talk tonight and everything else, we won't talk on your main man, Russell Wilson, quite yet. We'll get into that a little later on in the show. But I want to ask you, when it comes to your personal space and things going on, are you dismissive as to what goes around you, or are you a bit more of a... what's the word? Are you a bit more nosy as to what goes on around you?
I used to be more nosy. Now I'm more of the, if it don't bother me, it don't bother me. Like, it's none of my business. I want people staying out of my business, so I'm going to stay out of their business. I'm curious. Like, it's someone, like, yeah, I am curious sometimes as to how things work. I'll put it that way. But you know, I, as a general rule, I'm definitely not a gossip, and I just let sleeping dogs lie.
Like, if you see something, like you're going to take your dog for a walk and you see somebody doing something, do you ask, or do you just go, he's just doing his shit and it doesn't bother me any? Or if he's doing something nefarious? Because the reason why I ask is we were at Browns on, I think, Tuesday night or Monday night after the show. I can't remember what night it was. Doesn't much matter. But The servers at Browns there, they were looking out the window and there was some cat doing something that wasn't normal. And it's just, it wasn't normal. So they got a little bit concerned. They were going to phone the cops, and they had snow piled up there where the parking lot is. And that's just where they pile the snow. And there was this guy chipping away at some snow and whatever. And they were freaking out because it's not normal, right? And I was like, who cares? Like, we know these people because it's right across the street from the house, right?
So when I'm
like,
you're semi-regulars,
like, yeah. So I'm like, who cares? Like, they're just like that guy's playing in snow. Who gives a fuck? Like, whatever. And on it went. And then they got a little concerned. And I said, what do you guys care? Like, we were the only people in there.
Did it look like he was looking for something? Or
no, he was just digging. Like, I don't. And that was the first thing I said is, are you looking for something? Like, what? Like, that was came to my thought. Maybe he's looking for something, or maybe he's doing, I don't know.
Was he buggered up?
No, he was just doing, digging a hole or whatever it was. And I was kind of laughing about it. And then they got quite concerned. They were going to call the cops. And I said, if you guys are the TikTok generation, maybe he's building a ramp for a TikTok video or some fucking thing. I don't know. Like, who cares?
No, when you put it that way, like, it's, I do ask people, like, if I'm dog walking or whatever like that, if the people are talking on their phone, just walking around, like it's happening before. You need a hand? You lost? What's going on? Like, I do have an eye on that kind of stuff.
Yeah. It's just like, what are you, like, I'm not nosy. Like, I could care less, man. Like, whatever, dude. As long as you're not wrecking my shit or my neighbor's shit or people I know shit. Because, and that's another problem you got, Dave, is that if you were to be breaking into a car, like if I'm walking by going for my daily walk and someone's breaking into a car, I'd look and say, what's going on? Oh, I locked my keys in there. I'd be like, all right. Because I'm naive and don't pay attention, I guess. I got other things going on in my head, but yeah, it was just odd. And turns out the guy was just making a bike ramp on this fucking snow thing for probably a TikTok video.
Huh.
Like, it was just, I don't know, it's just odd.
It is odd. You know, and I've, you know, there's, I've been in an alley or something like that, and someone's up, like, this wasn't sitting right. Yeah, he said I could take that. Yeah, okay. I'm taking a picture of your plate, eh? I don't want you to. Yeah,
don't. Then don't take that.
Yeah, don't matter. I'll take a picture of your plate. Oh. In fact, Jasper was rifty one time when I took a picture of a guy's plate.
Yeah, it's just the whole, I'm not nosy. In general, I don't care. But if you see something that looks nefarious, it probably is nefarious, right? It's funny.
I got pretty decent Spidey sense, so. Yeah,
I don't care enough is the thing. Like, I'm like, oh, whatever, dude.
Yeah, but I don't want people getting ripped off, because I've had shit stolen from me, and I if I can prevent it, someone else, friend or not friend, like I'll stop.
No, like if it's in a neighborhood, absolutely, I'll say something. I'm like, hey, man, like don't be doing that. Like, don't be doing that.
Yeah.
And then they usually run away because they don't want to be caught. They don't want the trouble, right? But if it's in the middle of a parking lot at a neighborhood pub, I'm like, dude, just do whatever you want, man. As long as not
Yeah, if you're digging in snow, like, yeah, I might ask what you're up to, but like, otherwise, let's
that,
just
and I should have
stick a
asked the
mist in
girls.
you.
I said maybe he lost something like 4 days ago, and they piled the snow up, and he's looking for it instead of having to pay the $200 to get it back into his vehicles of AMA or whatever. I don't know. I don't know. It's just an odd thing. Question number two, I got for you. I know you. I sprung it on you a little bit right before we got on the air tonight. Russell Wilson got himself in a little bit of trouble today. I know you don't know the details, but it don't much matter. There was a situation with his charity that only 23% of all the money that comes to it is going to actual charity and the like. He had a bad year. They got a new coach coming in. The new coach, he said he ain't having his personal coach, personal trainer. Russell Wilson isn't having this guy around anymore. Did the Broncos not do any research? Like, now that it's over, this first year's over, did the Broncos not do any research at all on your main man, Russell Wilson?
It doesn't seem that way. Because it sounds like he's quite a nozzle. Like he doesn't
Oh.
care. He considers himself, from what I've read, and I don't know squat, that he considers himself above the fray. And even someone shared this with me. I think it was Kyle Brent. No, I don't know. I'm not gonna put a name, but it was someone saying, talking about like an NFL awards show. And then as the quarterbacks and all the big names are coming by, it's like, hey, how you doing? Hey, how you doing? And then Russell Wilson and his wife come through and he's like, oh, no questions, please. Acts like he's all that, like he's fucking royalty. And that pisses me
Well,
off.
who's
You
his? Is,
know?
he's got a like a pop star wife, Sierra, or whatever her name is.
Yeah.
So
And
that
that's
probably doesn't rub off the right way either. Like the pops, like the mega pop stars come across quite.
Is she a mega pop star?
I think so.
Okay. Like I don't like I don't know.
I'm fairly certain she's a like not Swiftie pop star, but she's up there.
She ain't doing the Super Bowl halftime. Like, is
No.
Riri asking her to come on stage with her?
No, she won't even be a
Oh
guest to shine Ray Ray's shoes. I don't think, but that's just my opinion. But anyway.
yeah. But anyways, like yeah, so it seems like he's a bit of a bit of an asshole that considers himself above the fray, and that bothers me because you're the foot as the quarterback, you got to be a leader, and if guys think you're a douchebag, how can you lead when you're a douchebag?
If your peers think you're a nozzle, you're probably a nozzle.
Yeah, for sure,
That's just
and
the way it is, yeah.
that rubs me the wrong way. This you mentioned about the charity thing. That's not uncommon. I'm not excusing it. Like it's a lot of these guys set up their charities to A, use as a bit of a tax haven, and B, to get their posse paid. That's what they do. And that way
Yeah, you're probably
they
right.
can.
Like it just came across today, and I was wondering what your take was on it. But it just seemed like an awfully high number that was given away. Like I know there's some other charities around this great land of ours that give away a really big chunk, not or they take a big chunk of change and they don't give much out. And I don't know the numbers on it, but it's just like, oh man, Wilson just can't get out of his own way.
Yeah, because there's websites dedicated to that. If you're gonna donate to charity, you look up that charity's name, and they'll tell you what percent of donations are actually going to the work they say they're doing.
Yeah.
Because I think it,
That
I
Susan B. Gorman one's a bad one. The cancer one. That one doesn't give much money back to the cancer site. So old Susie, she takes home a pretty good chunk of change.
yeah, like so many of these, right? Like a lot of administration costs, right?
Yeah.
Like. So you can't have, yeah, you can't, whatever, people are going to use anything they can to not everybody. Some people are going to do anything they can to make a buck. And if they could do it, you piggybacking off a legitimate cause, then they're going to do it because they're grifters. And this is what grifters do.
Dave, we'll get in the Super Bowl talk throughout the night here. I put it out on the old Twitter machine. A bunch of podcast creators, guys that support our shows, people that follow us on Twitter. I asked for their predictions for what's gonna happen on Sunday. during the big game. I'll talk about those during the show throughout the night. Get one or two here and there and everywhere. But man, it seems like it's a split decision right down the line. Who's going to win this game? And who's not? It's going to be. I think it's going to be a very good football game. Now that you like the line's not moving at all. It's 1.5. Minus 1.5 for the Eagles. I don't care about the lines, who wins or loses. I'm not a big sports bettor by any means, but I think it's going to be a good football game. Do you have, okay, I know you like watching the big game alone, as do I. I might venture out a little bit because I don't have a dog in the fight or a horse in the race on this one, so I might venture out a little bit. When you used to be a venturer and go out and or to parties, what was a have to have to when you walked in the door? Okay, one, what were you bringing to the party, and what had to be there to make sure you were going?
More than one TV with the game on it, enough seating, and what do I bring? I make a pretty mean chili, but it's been a long time since I've done that. I've made a hot potato salad. And then I've taken the last 4 or 5 years. I make Italian meatballs in a nice red sauce. They're pretty good.
I was on hungryfan.com today looking at different recipes and stuff to maybe brew something up. And I couldn't believe the stats that they had on this thing about what the money that's spent on Super Bowl Sunday alone across the United States, $14.8 billion gets spent on booze and food and the like. Like, that could solve a lot of problems with schools and situations around the United States. Like, that's a ton of dough, man.
That is a bit, because, you know, some – There's high end parties, right? Someone's fucking gonna do a pig on a spit, right? It's a big deal for a lot of people, and good on you if it's your thing. It's your thing, you know. Where are you going? We're going to JoJo's house. Isn't that guy a dick? Oh, but you should see his spread. He has the best TV, and he's gonna have filet. Steak bites, and he roasts a pig for afterwards. Like, yeah, I don't know.
I think it's great. Like, it's Super Bowl. I talked about 14:20 in the morning this morning, how the Super Bowl is more of an event for the masses, and it gets you out of that January lull that we have after Christmas, and it gets you out of that February lull that comes around, and people are a little, not, I wouldn't say down, but they're a little, the blues, I guess you could say. And Super Bowl's a way to hop into spring a little bit, and it's a great event. The game is I want to say for 98% of the people watching it, the game is secondary. It doesn't mean a bunch, because even if you're a football fan, if your team's not in it, you either are cheering against the team to not win it, or you're a football fan. And that's about 2% of football fans who watch it for the game of football.
Yeah, it gets a ton of eyes that aren't normal football watchers. So, excuse me, that's for sure. Like, and it makes you wonder, right? Like, but it's something to do, and everybody likes something to do, right? Like, it's
nothing draws a crowd, right?
Yeah, you know, and then you know, you don't have to watch the game. You can watch the commercials, watch Rihanna and piddle around, but it. To have a decent Super Bowl party, you if you're going to be contributing and what have you, you got to be there at least an hour, hour and a half before the game.
Yeah.
So you can set up. You see, like, am I going to have oven space? Am I going to have this? What do I got to do? Do we got to grab some ice? Like, you know, you got to be ready, because there's nothing worse than a last second, like, oh, so we forgot this. Don't be that guy.
Even worse is when the game gets going and the guy and guy and his wife, or guy and his girlfriend, or two girls, or two guys who don't know what the fuck's going on, are just there to actually be part of the party and not watch the game. And I'm not besmirching, always comes up on Thursdays for some reason. I'm not besmirching these people who do this, because all the power to them, they want to be part of something on a Sunday. But showing up when the kickoff's just about to happen, or the anthem is just about to happen, now you're starting to pay attention a little bit more to your prop bets and what's going on, and someone shows up and you got to do the handshake and the hug and the like, that's That's a little annoying. Show up like half an hour before, because then if you don't know what's going on, I will inform you what's going on. I will tell you the two teams are playing. I will tell you what you should watch. I should tell you what's going on. If you don't know, because everybody who comes in who doesn't know, they come in late and they never know what they're talking about.
Yeah, or they're just talking about what someone already talked about, you know. And it's the easiest crowd to work as well. Like, you know, who do you got? Oh, this, oh, that.
Say whatever, man. It doesn't.
You can say whatever and be
You can say the
whoever.
Bills, and if someone doesn't even know the Bills aren't even playing. Like, all right,
Yeah, or
right
just yeah, just
on.
but just yeah, be quiet and watch and that's the thing. Like, it's the game, and you know, the joy of watching the game by myself. Well, with my family, is that A, I'm watching the game, I'm not being interrupted. And B, if you know, if all of a sudden I got a case of violent diarrhea, I can hit pause, deal with that, come back, and then not that I normally get violent diarrhea. I haven't had violent diarrhea in quite some time. But
Well,
I have the ability to hit pause and come back to the game. And then I stay off social media. So that's another thing I like about it.
yeah, it's the food is the biggest thing. Like they're talking today. I was on hungryfan.com, and it's every day is chicken wing day across North America, and it's insane to me how many chickens, but they're only bred to be food. And let's not kid ourselves.
Oh,
Chick
yeah.
chickens are bred. Like, yes, there is chicken farms, and yes, there is the thing. There is some cruelty there, but chickens are only bred to be food. And that's just factual. That is
Yes.
100% factual. PETA, come at me. I don't care. But they're talking 1.38 billion chicken wings are going to be eaten in the United States of America on Sunday afternoon, Sunday evening.
The following is a presentation of the Belly Up Sports Media Network.